Today's topic is mutually exclusive events. Two events, A and B, are mutually exclusive if they cannot happen at the same time. Illustrations. Number one, going to school and going back home from school. The first event here is going to school, and the second event is going back home from school. These two events cannot happen at the same time. It is impossible for anyone to be going to school and going back home from school at the same time. Therefore, these two events are mutually exclusive events. Illustration number two, getting an even number and getting an odd number if a die is rolled once. If a die is rolled, these are the possible outcomes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. The first event in the second illustration is getting an even number. Let us represent this by A. So the possible outcomes in event A are 2, 4, and 6. The second event is getting an odd number. Let us represent this by B. The possible outcomes in event B are 1, 3, and 5. These two events cannot happen at the same time. If a die is rolled once, you either get an even number or an odd number. You cannot get an even number and an odd number at the same time. Also, we can see that there are no common possible outcomes between event A and event B. Therefore, these two events are mutually exclusive events. Using a Venn diagram, let us say circle A is for event A. The possible outcomes are 2, 4, and 6. Circle B is for event B. The possible outcomes are 1, 3, and 5. We can see that A intersection B is an empty set. Mutually exclusive events are also called disjoint events. Problem number one, a die is rolled. Find the probability of getting a number less than 4 or a number greater than 4. If a die is rolled, the possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. These are the outcomes in the sample space. S here means sample space. The first event in the problem is getting a number less than 4. Let us represent this event by A. The possible outcomes are 1, 2, and 3. The second event is getting a number greater than 4. Let us represent this event by B. The possible outcomes in event B are 5 and 6. These two events cannot happen at the same time. If a dice rolled, it is not possible to get a number less than 4 and at the same time greater than 4. Also, there are no common possible outcomes between event A and event B. Therefore, these two events are mutually exclusive events. If event A and event B are mutually exclusive, then the probability of event A or event B is equal to the sum of their respective probabilities. In symbols, P of A or B is equal to P of A plus P of B. The probability of event A is equal to the number of possible outcomes in event A divided by the number of all outcomes in the sample space. In event A, there are 3 possible outcomes, 1, 2, 3. And in the sample space, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 outcomes. So the probability of event A is equal to 3/6. The probability of event B is equal to the number of possible outcomes in event B divided by the number of all outcomes in the sample space. 1, 2, there are 2 possible outcomes in event B. So the probability of event B is equal to 2/6. This is now equal to 3/2/6. This is now equal to 5/6. So the probability of getting a number less than 4 or a number greater than 4 is equal to 5/6. Problem number 2. Kayla has 6 red marbles, 5 white marbles, and 4 blue marbles in a box. She picks up 1 marble at random. What is the probability that she picks up a red marble or a blue marble? The first event here is picking up a red marble, and the second event is picking up a blue marble. These two events cannot happen at the same time. It is not possible for Kayla to pick up 1 marble at random that is red and blue at the same time. So these two events are mutually exclusive events. Let us add first the marbles. 6 plus 5 plus 4 is equal to 15. So there are a total of 15 marbles. The probability of picking up a red marble or a blue marble is equal to the probability of picking up a red marble plus the probability of picking up a blue marble. The probability of picking up a red marble is equal to the number of red marbles divided by the total number of marbles. There are 6 red marbles and the total number of marbles is 15. So the probability of picking up a red marble is equal to 6 over 15 plus the probability of picking up a blue marble. The probability of picking up a blue marble is equal to the number of blue marbles divided by the total number of marbles. There are 4 blue marbles, so this is equal to 4 over 15. So plus 4 over 15. This is now equal to 6 plus 4 over 15. This is now equal to 10 over 15 or 2/3. So the probability that Kayla picks up a red marble or a blue marble is equal to 2/3.